Dear students, in the previous video we were discussing coordination compounds 1 of BSc 5th semester paper 1. In those sessions we completed some of the important terminologies of coordination compounds and oxidation, determination of oxidation number of coordination complex we discussed. So now another important concept is coordination number. The name itself indicates coordination number, it's a number. It's the number of a coordination bond which is present around a central metal ion, or we can also define as it's the number of electron pair donated by the ligand. It's also called as coordination number of central metal atom. So in order to identify the central coordination number of a central metal atom, so if you just count the number of bond, it is enough. The number of bond is equal to the coordination number. So in order to identify the coordination number of a complex, you must familiar with the nature of ligand, that is whether it is monodentin, bidentin, tridentin, because all the ligands cannot form a same number of bond. So monodentin ligand form only a single bond, bidentin double bond, tri triple bond, tetra four bonds, hexa six bonds. Like this, if the ligands varies, their bonding natures varies. You must know how many number of lone pair of electron which is donated by the ligand to the central metal atom. So now let us see some examples in order to understand the coordination number. So if it is very easy, one in that if a complex contains monodentin ligand, it is very easy. That is, the number of monodentin ligand is equal to the coordination number. If bidentin, tridentin, that is different. So let us see one by one. So you take the complex. Here there are six water molecules are present. So water is a monodentin ligand, that's why the coordination number is 6. And in this complex, tetrachloro, four monodentin chlorine ligands are present. So that's why its coordination number is 4. And in this complex, hexaamino cobalt 3 complex, here it has 6 ammonia, that's why so the coordination number is 4. And in silver complex, it has 2 ammonia, that's why the coordination number is 3. And the nickel tetracarbonyl, so coordination number is 4. So here, so you just look at this molecule, oxide. Okay, so the coordination number is 4. So it can form, there are 4 oxygen, so it can form 4 bonds. And this molecule, so dichloro, so diamino dichloro complex, here it has chloride and so amine as a ligand, so 2 amine and 2 chloro chloride ligands are present, totally 4. The coordination number is 4. It's very simple that the number of monodentin ligand which is present in the coordination sphere is nothing but the coordination number. So now let us see the polydentin ligand. So now let us see the oxalate, trice oxalate, so ferrate, so iron 3 complex. So in this case, so each oxalate can form 2 bonds. So totally there are 3 oxalate ion. There are 3 oxalate ion. So the coordination number is 6. That means you have to multiply it by each number of bond. So if there are 3 bidentin ligand, so you have to multiply it by 2. Why? Because bidentin ligand can form 2 bonds. That's why you have to multiply it by 3. Suppose if it is tridentin ligand is present, you have to multiply the number of ligands with 3. So similarly, take another example, ethane 1,2-diamine. It's a bidentin ligand. It can form 2 bonds. So there are 2 ethane 1,2-diamine. That's why the coordination number is 4. And EDTA, you know, ethylene diamine tetraacetate. this is the exadentin ligand. That is, this can form six bonds with the central metal ion. That's why the coordination number is 6. So dear student, once again, it's very easy to identify the coordination number only when you are familiar with the nature of ligand. So that is, so the if ligand is monodentin, the total number of ligand is nothing but the coordination number. If it is bidentin ligand, you have to multiply the total number of ligands with its ligacity, that is, so 2, 3, 4, it depends on ligand. So this is very easy concept. Just by looking at the complex itself, you can identify the coordination number of central metal ion. Next is Vernier steel. You know, Alfred Vernier is called as father of coordination chemistry. First time he started to synthesize the coordination compound in the laboratory. So while synthesizing and based on the experimental observation, he proposed his theory. That theory is called as Vernier's theory. So let us see the postulates of Vernier's theory. According to Vernier, a central metal atom of a coordination compound possesses two types of valency. So one is primary valency and secondary valency. So this primary valency is ionizable valency and it is satisfied by negative ion. So primary valency is nothing but oxidation number of a central metal ion, +2, +3, +4 or sometimes 0. So this is ionizable valency. And secondary valency is nothing but coordination number of a ligand. It is also satisfied by a negative ion. So these ions or ligand which is surrounded the metal ion and they are located in a proper position around the metal atom to form a perfect and geometry. So this is depends on the number of ligand which is present around the central metal atom. If it is two ligands are present, the expected geometry is linear. If there are three ligands around the central metal atom, so this is trigonal planar. If it is four, the expected is either square planar or tetrahedral. If it is five, trigonal bipyramidal. If it is six, so hexagonal. So we are going to discuss about geometry in detail in the coming classes. So now these are the important postulates. So Vernier's theory explains only about three things. One is primary valency, secondary valency, and it predicts a geometry of the complexes. So now let us see this table. So you can come to know the difference between primary and secondary valency. If you take the first complex, hexacyano iron complex, here the oxide iron is in +2 state. So primary valency is 2, secondary valency is 6. As I told, primary valency is nothing but oxidation state of central metal ion. Secondary valency is nothing but coordination number of central metal atom. You must remember this. And if you take tetracyano nickel complex, so nickel is in +2 state, so that's why its primary valency is 2, and there are 4 cyanide monodentin ligands are present, that's why the secondary valency is 4. And if you take tetrahydroxy zincate complex, so in this, so zinc is in +2 state, that's why primary valency is 2, and there are 4 hydroxy groups are present. These are monodentin ligand. It forms 4 bonds, that's why the secondary valency is 4. And if you take tetracarbonyl nickel complex, this is a neutral complex, and so this is also neutral ligand, and this is a neutral metal atom. So that's why, so its charge is 0, that's why its primary valency is 0. And it has 4 ligands, so it can form 4 bonds with the central atom. That's why the coordination number is 4. That's why the secondary valency is 4. And if you take this complex, so hexacyano, so iron 3 complex, this is 2 complex. Here iron is in +3 state, that's why primary valency is 3 and secondary valency is 6.